Greetings. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to watch this whole video to gain understanding. Thank you, Brother Arie, for your challenge. I will now examine the final portion of your comment. Did Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob had ever mentioned Jesus is God? What about Moses? Did he ever mention Jesus is God? Think of it, Jesus is not God. I believe I have already provided the logical truth in part two, brother. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob did not need to know the name of Yeshua. Your comment is an exact parallel to this, brother. Did they each individually or collectively ever say Jesus is God? The reality is they did not need to, brother. The premise of your jihad is that if Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob did not say it, it cannot be true. That is false logic, brother, and fails immediately on too many counterexamples. Did Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob ever mention the virgin birth? They did not. So by your logic, Messiah could not have been born of a virgin. Did Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob ever worship a religion called Islam? They did not. So by your logic, Islam could not be a valid religion. Did Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob ever see a written Quran or hold one? No, they did not. So by your logic, no Quran could be a true revelation from the God of Abraham, Isaac, or Jacob. Did Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob ever hear of a man named Muhammad? No, they did not. So Muhammad could not be a real prophet. I will stop with those four examples, brother. However, the list of counterexamples that falsify your logic is endless. Did Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob had ever mentioned Jesus is God? What about Moses? Did he ever mention Jesus is God? Think of it, Jesus is not God. The very same logic applies to Moses and to any other singular prophet of God, brother. Prophet Isaiah revealed that a virgin would become pregnant with a son. Isaiah 7:14, therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, a virgin will be with child and bear a son, and she will call his name Emmanuel. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Notice, brother, God himself will provide the sign of the virgin. But only prophet Isaiah revealed this sign until it happened. Prophet Malachi revealed that God would come to his temple as a prophet. Malachi 3:1, see, I am going to send my messenger, and he will clear the way before me. Then the Lord you seek will suddenly come to his temple, the messenger of the covenant you desire. See, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. Then the Lord you seek will suddenly come to his temple. His temple, not the temple of Baal. His temple, the messenger of the covenant you desire, a messenger, a prophet. Only prophet Malachi revealed with such crystal clarity that God would come to his temple as a prophet. But prophet Malachi, prophet Isaiah, and prophet John all corporately prove that Jesus is God come in the flesh to his temple as a prophet. Please understand, brother, this is the heart of the true Injil, the gospel or good news of Yeshua the Messiah. For hundreds of years, more than 1,000 years, God sent prophets to reveal his plan to redeem mankind from sin. But not every prophet revealed every detail of the plan. Nor did they need to, brother. Prophet Isaiah did not need to cause 10 plagues because the Jews were not in bondage to Egypt during his mission. Prophet Daniel served a very specific purpose in fulfilling God's liberation from Babylonian exile after 70 years. But part of what Daniel did was simply to show King Cyrus that Cyrus was foretold by name. Prophet Isaiah foretold Cyrus would be king. Isaiah 45:1, "Thus says the Lord to Cyrus his anointed, whom I have taken by the right hand, to subdue nations before him and to loose the loins of kings, to open doors before him so that gates will not be shut." And the word of God convinced Cyrus to cooperate in God's plan. So, brother, God knows what he wants each prophet to say, meaning when God wants the specific details to be revealed and understood. I pray, brother, that you would decide to honestly think about the great God of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Isaiah, and Daniel. God's word is eternal, brother, and no man can change it or destroy it. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.